the formula is very simple. I mean, we are focusing on necessity-driven items and services. In other words, I mean, if you build a shopping center and you have a supermarket and you have a drugstore and you have a bank and a few other necessity item or services providers, providers of necessity items or services, then you know that you have guaranteed a flow of people that would routinely visit your shopping center. And of course, you have to provide them with clean and safe environment, a well-lit parking lot, ease of parking, and so on. But once you've done all that, you know they will come. And also, you need to have to be present in demographics that, of course, cater to all that. Once you've done all that, the formula works.
So it's, I mean, like on an e-commerce platform, it's eyeballs. Eyeballs equal advertising. I mean, it's the same thing in bricks and mortar, right? It's just you want people coming through. That creates cash flow. That is
that
stable
in turn, exactly. Now you look. I believe that demographics is number one. The makeup of the tenancy is number two, and convenience is number three. These are the three pillars or the three legs of that stool.
Right.
And you need to have all of them. You need to have great demographics. You need to, that begets great tenants. And if you provide great services, people would love to come.
And you're all over the world. You're in 20 countries. So which countries, given that three-legged stool, where is it strongest right now?
The U.S. is recovering. There's no question about that. The Nordic region is a great place to be. The Nordic region is probably the best kept secret in the retail world.
What's happening up there?
What is happening there is that you have very strong economies, as I call it. These are economies that they still make things.
Right.
In Sweden and in Finland and in Denmark and in Norway, and also in the Baltics, by the way. And you're looking at AAA rated countries with GDP per capita that is equal or greater than that of the United States or Canada. You're looking at a combined population of about 25 million people, and yet people view them as three or four or five separate little countries, which is not the case. I keep telling people that the distance from Stockholm to Helsinki is almost the same distance as it is from Miami to Orlando, which we run here in the U.S. Right. from the same office. And over there, these are two distinct countries. So if you look at it, a bird's eye look, then you look at one region that is more or less the size of Canada. I mean, population-wise, of course, much more condensed. With as transparent as it gets, rule of law, real rule of law, a very liquid currency, usually mainly the euro, the Swedish krona, purchasing power, and not as saturated with retailers as other parts of the world.
The largest shareholder in the company recently sold 4 million shares.
Yes.
Why?
Look, this is the first time we sold stock in almost 20 years. And sometimes you sell stock, you want to delever like everybody else. I mean, when you mentioned that a large shareholder sold 4 million shares, that shareholder bought about 24 million shares in the last 5 years. So I guess when you put it together, then you get the rationale for that. It's time to deliver. It's time to pay back your debts.